So a question I get asked by my clients a lot is, hey, Yoshi, went through the process of getting pre-qualified, and the individual informed me I didn't qualify for a loan at this particular bank, at this particular lender. Should I give up the hopes, give up on searching for another house, or should I go try and get pre-qualified with another lender? Is there any hope at all? What's your answer to that?
So I have a very simple answer to that. No. No, don't ever give up, right?
Right.
I have, that's where this success story comes in. I have a listing agent that was selling a home, and she had a buyer's agent come in with a buyer, and basically the buyer was qualified. He had a pre-qualification letter that we just spoke about.
Yep.
3 days before the settlement deadline, the lender called him up and said, you do not qualify, the loan is dead.
Oh.
So the listing agent, who knows me,
yeah,
said to the buyer's agent, you have to get your client in touch with Marcus. Marcus will take a look at it. So I grabbed the borrower, ran the numbers, took it to an underwriter, ran it through what's called DU, or direct underwrite, with Fannie Mae.
Okay.
I got an approved eligible. We closed that gentleman in 8 days.
Wow.
So I'm just telling you, in the course of doing loans for almost 16 years, I've had so many clients who have had a pre-approval,
mm-hmm,
and it's not worth the letter that it was written on. And they've come to me, and I've saved the day a lot of times because I just ask the right questions, I guess. There are a lot of good lenders out there, but there are a lot of lenders probably out there that need to do a little better on what they do and asking and digging that client and really finding out what's going on.
Very cool. Got it. If you don't mind me asking, actually, that brings up a good point. I was chatting with a bunch of friends. I belong to a real estate mastermind, and we meet once a month, and I was chatting with some friends, and there seemed to have been a particular bank, I won't state the bank, a larger bank, and this particular bank, for whatever reason, was giving out pre-qualified letters to through the experience of the gentleman in the mastermind, a lot of his experience that when it was time to actually go towards the financing part and making sure that would happen, the buyer really didn't qualify. However, you know, just in our mastermind, there were several stories, several of us that had gone through where we were representing a seller, buyer was pre-qualified by this particular bank, it didn't happen, then we had to start all over. You know, as a seller, that buyer had to start over, we just had to decide if we wanted to wait for them to start over or just cancel the contract and put it back on the market. And this particular bank came up several times. What is the process that, you know, let's say general process, and then maybe the difference, I don't know if you could share, what makes a pre-approval stronger versus what you said before, not even worth the paper it's written on? What's the general process of it, and what should people be looking for to go, this is a stronger pre-approval letter, if there is anything to look at?
So that's a great question, and I would always 100% refer back to the loan officer. Like I said, there's a lot of good loan officers out there.
Mm-hmm.
There is a lot of loan officers who maybe work for a big bank and make a little less money, let's say,
yeah,
working for a bank. And I don't think that the underwriting or the pre-underwriting standards at a bank at the loan officer level when you walk into a bank is at the level of which someone like me, who's a broker,
mm-hmm,
my whole reputation is based on making something happen and making that client happy so they're going to tell somebody about it. I can't hide behind a big bank.
Right.
So I think the pre-qualification letter is going to come down to your loan officer and what he knows, and if he knows his stuff, and if he's got connections with underwriters or whoever he can sit down to, mm-hmm, or with to get that pre-approval or that pre-qualification done, and it's worth the paper that it's written on. Now, having said that, I will tell you that sometimes you will write a pre-qualification letter and something comes up at the very end, or something comes,
sure,
up that nobody was anticipating.
Yep.
That's where a good loan officer comes in and says, I'm going to make this happen. And there's one thing that I've always said to the real estate agents that I work with: unless I tell the borrower about the problem, it's never a problem. This is why I have gray hair. This is why I have problems in life. I'm stressed all the time. Because you're a fixer of problems. And
yeah,
even the best plans made that you can do a pre-approval on, if something comes up, heck, it's your job to get that taken care of. It's not your job to tell the client.
Right.
After closing, if you want to share it with the client and say, gosh, this was close to dropping, just as a fun point,
yeah,
that's up to you. But I always come back to the loan officer. I think it has to do with the moxie and the knowledge of the loan officer.
Awesome. You know, that's funny you said that. I saw a quote that a buddy of mine put on Facebook real estate agents, definition of real estate agent, a problem solver, but that would be the same for you as well, a mortgage broker.
Exact same.
Constantly solving problems. Awesome, excellent. Well, we are going to go to a commercial break right now, but you're definitely going to want to stay tuned because Marcus has a really cool success story on leveraging the bank's money to build your own wealth. All right, Mohammed, please take us to commercial. With smartphones and technology making life a little easier, the Snap Leash has also been designed to make life a little easier for you and your pup. Whether you're out on a stroll in the park or possibly a walk through the city or maybe even a hike up in the mountains, the Snap Leash is the perfect leash for you. The Snap Leash can easily and conveniently convert it to 7 leashes, making the Snap Leash the most convenient leash in the world. What other leash do you know that is 7 leashes in one? With the Snap Leash having appearances on the Today Show in New York City, TV4 in Dallas, Texas, and ABC4 on Midday, Utah, you are definitely going to want to take a peek at what the Snap Leash can do for you and your best friend. Make life a little easier for you and your pup and visit www.snapleash.com today.